Daughter refuses to wake up after nap, then mother looks closer at her face and rushes to call 911. Summertime brings sunshine and warmer weather. This is usually a fun time for many kids who are off school and can enjoy numerous outdoor activities. But parents should remain vigilant. Sun and heat can certainly bring fun and joy, but they can also be very dangerous. Heatstroke is one good example. We've previously written about being cautious when leaving your kids in the car when really hot outside. Now, Mother Jennifer Ibma wants to warn parents of another scenario which can cause a child to have a heat stroke during warm temperatures. The mother's experience was so upsetting that she later took to her Facebook page to share her story. On July 14, Jennifer decided to share what had happened that evening on her Facebook page as a warning to all parents out there. The experience had clearly shaken the young mother. It was a hot summer evening and Jennifer was about to check up on her little girl, Anastasia, who was in her bedroom. Jennifer noticed that Anastasia was deep in sleep, but also extremely hot. As it would turn out, the girl was suffering from a severe heat stroke, despite that she hadn't even been in the sun that day. Luckily, Anastasia would be fine, but Jennifer thinks all parents should be more cautious when it's especially hot, whether outdoors or indoors. This was my evening. This was the scariest moment I've had to imagine. This is severe heat stroke. There is nothing scarier than not being able to wake your baby up. This is clear proof a child doesn't need to be in the sun to get heat stroke. It took us 20 minutes to wake her up. When ambulance came, they came with investigators because they didn't know what to expect, as did I. This was proof how fast things change. Anastasia put herself for a nap. I had no idea how hot her bedroom was until I went to wake her up soaked in sweat, red face, boiling and unable to wake her for 15 minutes. Ambulance arrived faster than I could have ever imagined and took her sugars, which were 1.2 and should be above 4. They administered sucrose and in minutes she started crying, clearly scared. No, it is not my fault this happened to her, but it is hard not to blame yourself. This is a lesson learned and hopefully other parents can take something from this and make sure you are checking the rooms in your house, because that can be as dangerous as a hot car. Still, I'm shook and I can't imagine what would have happened if I didn't go check on her. We definitely had God on our side yesterday, and I am thankful for emergency services and Jay, who came as fast as possible.